pocket. And sometimes I notice they show up on the podcast, and I'm like, maybe I should just have it out.
People think you have a rectangular penis.
They might. They might. I was thinking about that.
That'd be actually, like, you should, we should zoom in on it sometimes. Just
yeah.
To...
Like here, I'll put it back in. I don't know if they can actually see my leg in that camera.
Yeah. Yeah, we see it.
Oh, you do? Yeah. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, crap. That... Yeah, see, I don't know how that happens because for me, you and I are balanced at this point, like in volume.
Yeah, I think you just get. I think you might just get carried away and you just. And you just.
Do you think I go loud? Like, it's too loud? Oh, wait, let's see. No! Ah!
Yeah, that was like the loudest it can be.
Okay, that's the
loudest. And sometimes it's louder than that.
Oh, dang.
Okay. But we don't need to test it out. Okay. I just know. Right. I just know for sure.
Because I don't know how, like, how these are balanced. Like, either you're not going that loud, like, I'm going over the top with the volume.
Yeah. That's,
or,
that's it, for sure.
That's got to be it, right? Because both of our balances right now are the same, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd say.
And headphone volumes, are we the same there, too?
I don't know. The headphone volumes are different because the headphones, like, this is more like... These cones don't like block in a lot of sound. It's like it sounds a lot more open, and those are locked in. So the headphones are different.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah. Cause I don't know why every time we start the recording or are testing it, it's mm-hmm. like I think I sound quieter for some reason.
Yeah.
That's so weird. But this is balanced. This is great. This sounds
yeah.
Good.
I also you noticed that my mouth is this far away from the mic.
Oh, and am I close?
And
yeah.
No, you're not. You're not close enough.
Oh, I'm not close enough.
It's not been a problem after we do the compression and limiting thing. It's not a problem, but I'm just saying that's a factor. Right?
Yeah,
that's a factor.
I put it away from my mouth because I mean I remember when we go to sometimes like do these things like especially towards the beginning I remembered editing and stuff too, right?
Mm-hmm. Well,
I remember
hopefully
there was
you remember
a distinct...
editing. We did that a lot.
Yeah, we have done that a lot. We continue to, but like I remember this as well that like my mic sometimes would go a little bit too much, so I try and place it farther away from
my
face.
And that's good.
Yeah, yeah.
And even when you're singing, I saw you like.
That's what I was trying to do because I got afraid because I was like I have a distinct memory of like okay if I'm too close it's gonna clip.
Mm-hmm.
But it's so weird that in my headphones at least it sounds like. We're even. It's just so strange.
Right now, it's just hard to tell for me because when I'm talking, also like my everything else is like you hear yourself not through the headphones. You know.
Yeah, yeah.
Your mouth, your eyes, you're feeling yourself talking, and you also hear from the inside. So if it sounds the same to you, then it probably is, but I can't tell.
Okay.
It's hard to tell what you're doing sometimes.
It is hard to tell what you're doing.
Yeah.
And now we're in a parking lot.
Wait. What? We're inside of a van right now.
Yeah, we're inside of a van, but the van is inside of a parking lot.
Okay.
Because I'm just letting them know because, you know, we're not in our usual place. Even though they could never tell where we are exactly,
uh-huh.
I like to let them know. Like, we've been doing it at your house, you know, but then... My car,
mm-hmm.
its catalytic converter got jacked.
Yeah, just when you say your car, that people have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, like what type of car?
Or just, you know, because basically what you said was, we're in a parking lot because of my car.
Oh, because they don't know what happened to my car.
Yeah.
Well, it's because... Because
then you just say the catalytic converter.
Got jacked.
Well, yeah. Well, what does that mean?
I guess
what
maybe they don't know.
Got all jacked up, like, you know, just got fucked up where it got, drank some Mountain Dew. Like, who knows
what
it did.
Oh, that's true. Jacked doesn't exactly... The car was jacked. Now I'm really being confusing. Okay.
Yeah.
So someone stole my catalytic converter because I drive a Prius, and they're, for some reason, they have metals in them that are really valuable. So people have been...
Like from the Olympics?
It could be from the Olympics. I don't know,
maybe
platinum?
That's why.
Do they? They could use a platinum medal.
Yeah, I was just making a joke because you know, like Olympic medals.
Oh, like a. I mean, I guess a
gold,
medal.
Gold, silver, bronze.
A medal is literally a medal.
Most times it is. Sometimes it's plastic.
Yeah, if you get a cheap one. I remember those from, like, you know, the elementary years when you do, like, a competition, and they're like, here's a medal. And it's just, like, this plastic
thing in a bag. How are you going to teach kids, you know, how are you going to do it? It's pretty challenging.
I don't know.
How are you going to do it? Yeah, we should start updating the sound pads.
That would be nice.
Just to get, you know, clips from this or just other weird things that we can just click.
That'd be nice.
Yeah.
You know,
it would be nice to have a whole soundboard, or like, some people have iPads with just a bunch of sounds on it.
That would be super cool. I think we should try that. Can we connect it to this? There must be a way.
The same way we do on here.
Oh, gotcha. Just plug it in with an aux and then feed it in. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We should try it.
Yeah. And sadly, well, we'll see, but basically I had a tablet that I was trying out to be efficient for this FedEx business, but I gave it to my dad, but it was only $64, so we'll see what happens with the tablet, but maybe that could be the soundboard.
All right, yeah.
And maybe it can't be. But I like maybe that idea. Wait, but maybe there's like an app but maybe the app won't let you upload your own sounds. Maybe they will.
Maybe. You'll probably have to pay for it. I bet you anything it'll cost money.
Yeah,
but
maybe if it's $5, then it's worth it.
I'd say so, too. Definitely.
And it has to be your phone.
It can be my phone. That works.
Yeah, or...
Oh, because you got the Apple phone. Doesn't have an aux.
But
I get a dongle.
But the thing is, I've had this phone for since 2014.
Oh.
The beginning. In, like, January.
Dang.
Of 2014. Do you remember what even happened in 2014?
Oh man, that was before college for me. That's so long ago.
It's 2014. You were a sophomore.
Yeah, in high school. That's
yeah.
Yeah, man.
iPhone 7, and only recently has the screen cracked because I've started taking it out the case, kind of just as a way to do so much damage to it that I have to get a new one. It's kind of what it is.
Yeah.
I'm not like throwing it on the ground, but it's hard. This thing is slippery. It just falls out of your hand. Even if you're just like, if you're like this, it'll just go.
Yeah.
Like this.
Got to get a case.
Oh, no,
case on there.
But I had a case.
You did?
A lot of wooden cases, actually. But now I need a new phone. But if this is still serving me functionally, I can't. It just doesn't even make sense in my head to get a new one.
I know
right?
what you mean.
It's like this
I feel
one works.
The same way, yeah.
This one works. Well, it doesn't really work. And like the new iPhones, the phone isn't actually bigger, but the whole front side is a screen. So the screen's bigger.
Yeah.
I like that. Aside from that, I don't even know how they make the new ones better aside from them having newer, faster processing.
Yeah, you know, if I'm happy with my phone, like the one that I have currently, I probably shouldn't just... Like, you know, I've been keeping these in my pocket, and sometimes I notice they show up on the podcast, and I'm like, maybe I should just have it out.
People think you have a rectangular penis.
They might. They might. I was thinking about that.
That'd be actually, like, we should zoom in on it sometimes.
Like, here, I'll put it back in. I don't know if they can actually see my leg in that camera.
Yeah. Yeah, we see it.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Oh, crap.
That would be impressive and just horribly ineffective.
I know, right? Like, what would you do with something like this?
It would have to fold.
Even then, though, the ridges, it wouldn't be functionable.
Well, if it was that rigid,
yeah.
If it was just that, but attached, that would be worthless. But if it was made out of the regular material that a regular one is, you could like bend it around and still maybe have children.
But if it hardened, then you'd have just like this, and then you'd just be stuck.
No, that's not what I'm imagining.
That's what I was imagining.
Like if that was made out of a penis material?
Like if it wasn't an erect penis.
Yeah.
Then okay, maybe. But then it would always take this form. So you couldn't do anything with it. Like then you'd just be like,
I know. But I'm imagining like the erect penis still isn't, it isn't as hard as a, it's not as hard as a phone.
I mean, It's not, but it's still like it's not like pliable, you know? Like,
well, who knows if it's that thin and that wide? Maybe it will, like, the structure won't be able to support as that's what I'm imagining.
That's another thing. I think there's so many downsides. It would be so bad.
Yeah, I agree.
You'd just be stuck.
Uh-huh. It would suck.
With like a flap.
Yeah. Just kind of, which is it oriented this way? Or, I was always imagining it like this.
That's almost even worse. Can you imagine just like just
yeah.
That's awful.
No, I can't imagine. I have a pretty good imagination.
I'd say I can imagine it, but I don't want to because it sounds so terrible.
Yeah.
You know, it sounds awful.
Does sound awful. And speaking of imagination, that whole bit in the I guess it's two episodes ago, when people see this, the hot ones episode, mm-hmm. when I think the camera had cut out, but we were doing the whole bit about tsunami. You remember?
Tsunami.
So I was talking about, basically sometimes I'll just say a gibberish sentence and you're like, well, no, what are you talking about? And then I said, well, how long would it take for if there was a pilot flying over the Atlantic Ocean?
I do that, remember that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
And so like we went from you not understanding to you jumping on board to creating this whole fictional story about this hippopotamus sized woman causing tsunamis and the pilot wanting to kill her and all this stuff. So
yeah.
That's a testament to the creative mind. Who knows if it is genetic or if it is whatever else it would be.
Who knows?
A choice. Probably a choice.
I'd say a choice. I think anyone can make up anything.
Even Larry King.
Even
he's dead.
Even Larry King, I think.
He's dead.
I think if someone reincarnated him and somehow, like,
I don't think you're using
brought
that word
his mind
right.
back.
I don't think you're using that word.
Doesn't
right.
reincarnate mean like he's coming back?
Like, reincarnation is like this whole belief system about people, yes, being reincarnated, but in a different form or a different body.
What if he was reincarnated though in his same form?
Yeah, I think it would work, but I think it's like I don't know how to describe it, but it's like people make jokes about God, I don't know how to come up with a good example. It's not what people think it is, even if it's correct. You know, what if we reincarnated Larry King as a turtle? That's what people would think.
It's open-ended. I know what
yeah.
you mean. It is very open-ended.
If we like brought him back to life, though, yeah.
Yeah, if we brought him back to life, you know, if we hooked him up to the machine and we got his brain going again and mm-hmm. we made sure that his body was able to, you know, withstand,
yeah.
you know, the regular physical world that we live in.
Yeah.
Brought him back. I think he could still have an imagination.
Yeah.
I think that anybody can. I think it just takes a certain number of things. You got to just let your mind go, let it loose. And whatever comes out, comes out. And then
what if
you gotta...
What if it says to murder people?
That's bad. But, yeah. but I mean, if it's in, like, a story land, like an imaginary,
yeah.
like someone's writing, like...
No, but just let your mind go, and you're like, okay, I need to kill these people now.
Then what I would recommend is you stop, and you create it, use it in a maybe a creative fashion. Maybe, like, make a TV show, make a movie.
A video game where you can murder people and then do it in the video game.
Exactly. Like, there's another... I think your imagination was trying to say something else, that you should do that in a format that isn't in the physical world. Because mm-hmm. the imagination, remember, doesn't take place in the physical world. So sometimes imagination does not belong in the physical world because...
Okay.
Well, but dangerous.
Yeah. So you gotta recognize that some of the imaginations aren't meant to be transferred.
Exactly.
They're not meant to be used.
It's like South Park. That South Park episode where they're like, Imagination Land is opening, right? Like, there's like this portal, mm-hmm. and they have to like figure out how to close it because if all the imagination creatures get into the real world, shit's gonna go down.
Yeah.
Because Imagination Land isn't supposed to, you know, directly plug into reality, because then there's some scary stuff in Imagination Land that
yeah, that is scary.
Yeah, that aren't meant to be here.
Larry King could handle that, But what that really makes me think about is, you said a bunch of shit is about to happen. Is that what you said?
Yeah, shit's about to go down.
Okay, shit's about to go down. Okay, so that's bad, right? Shit going down.
Yeah.
Also, shit hitting the fan is bad.
I'd say shit hitting the fan is even like is even worse than shit going down. Like when people are like,
shit is about to go down. When you poop,
the shit goes down the toilet.
I mean, and that's a good process, isn't it?
Yeah.
And I think
unless it's in a basement and then a shit goes up.
You know, that's very true. I don't know why people don't say shit is about to go up.
Yeah, if that you're just sounds more terrifying. Shit's about to go up. Yeah, it's not supposed to go up.
That you're, actually scares me
in your
me
intestines?
More.
In your throat?
That's awful.
Okay, and then there's also like people have a lot of shit to do. Why are they calling the things they're about to do shit? And also, like, I got a bunch of shit in my house. Well, you shouldn't. It should be in the sewers.
That one makes more sense to me.
I got a bunch of shit, though.
And sometimes they're calling it, like, shit. Like, I got a bunch of shit in my house. Like, okay. It's not, like, when someone says that, you know it's not good. Like,
oh, but some people say good shit. They and do. That means good.
I just thought of that, too. Like, immediately before you said it, I was thinking in my mind, it was like, what if it's good shit? Some of that good shit that people
No, people
like.
Say, like, okay, like, at the end of a conversation, they're like, good shit. And then they fist bump. Like, they get it was a good job. You did a good job. Good shit.
Yeah. I mean...
Bad shit.
Is there no such thing as... Because, like, there can be a good shit, right? So maybe we're thinking about this in the wrong context. Maybe when people say, like... You know when people say shit is about to go down, right? Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's like, something exciting. It's like, shit is about to go down in this house. And everyone's like, yeah!
Shit's about to go down.
Yeah. And then there's, like, the...
It's about to go down. Like, they're coming.
Like, it's going to be bad. Yeah. So maybe... It's like there can be good shits and bad shits. Just mm-hmm. like with a shit. Like if you're going to have a like diarrhea, terrible shit, right? But if you have a good shit, it's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
You're like, normal process, I'm happy.
Like, yeah, but still people don't like it because it smells bad. Like imagine if we didn't have toilets, how bad life would be.
It would
relatively obviously.
If we had all
the
bad.
Other if we had all this other technology, but we didn't figure out that shit.
We'd still be back in the, like, medieval sewage system, which was literally just throwing your shit out into the streets. Disease
yeah, that's
and all.
Terrible.
Yeah.
But, like, I once heard, because I've done all this research on, like, off-grid kind of toilet systems, the poop smells exponentially worse after it's gotten wet.
Hmm.
But for some reason, when we do it into the water and it's submerged, then the most of the smell does not escape. But sometimes I've done it where the poop stacks on top of itself and then it smells bad.
Yeah.
You ever seen that? Like I think there's a small toilet bowl in the toilet I usually use. But also, in the mornings, for whatever reason, I have a major offload. And so it stacks up.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Like.
It's coming
coffee
up.
Can be a driving force, too. I have my morning coffee, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like, all right, have the morning shit. Kind of mm-hmm. like, you know, it's like morning
Mine's
coffee,
as soon as
morning
I wake
shit.
Up.
It's as Literally, soon as you wake up.
Yeah.
For me, it takes a little bit. You know, I wake up, doesn't happen quite yet. Usually when I have my first cup, my morning coffee, that's when I'm like morning shit time. Like, it's like my body has timed it to where it's
yeah.
like morning coffee, morning shit. Kind of
yeah.
in that order. But... I do know what you mean there. Sometimes the water isn't enough to contain the shit. And I don't know if the water engineers in the toilets, I don't know what they were thinking when they decided this is the amount of water. Maybe they
yeah.
maybe they don't shit very
Conservation.
Much.
Conservation.
That is a
yeah, There's
good
basically
point,
between
yeah.
1.2 gallons per flush up to like 2.5. And if you're just peeing in there, you shouldn't even be using 1 gallon of clean water because clean water shows up in the toilet.
Yeah.
Even
yeah.
if there's like residue, obviously, from previous flushes, it's not clean. But the water being put into the toilet, we've talked about this.
We have.
The water being put in the toilet is clean. Still has drugs in it, but it's clean relatively by commercial and FDA standards. It's clean. But there's people that can't drink water at other places, and we're putting it in our toilets, and we're pooping in it.
Yeah, we did talk about using shower water, mm-hmm. right? Like old shower water.
Yeah, pooping in the shower.
Pooping in the shower. You could do that too. It's not going to be a great, you know, cleanup.
Yeah. No, but they should. They definitely have archaic shower to toilet filtration systems. And archaic just mean that there's a lot better way to do it. And it's way easier if you're building a brand new house to just put the system in before all the walls are up and stuff, and you can wire the electrical. But it'd be very easy to build a brand new house, take the water from the shower, put it into your toilet.
It would be
so easy. And then the world would change. The world would change.
Yeah.
Plus, some of the soap would probably...
Yeah, I remember discussing that too. Like, there's no downside.
Yeah, even if you pee in the shower, who cares?
Yeah, then it would just go right into the...
Yeah, and if you're in Europe, I mean, not a big problem either.
I guess so. Well, do the Europeans like...
Well, if you're in the bathroom.
In Europe.
Yeah, wait. But if you're an American and you walk into the bathroom...
Yeah.
And you walk out, what are you?
You're a shitty American.
Well, you're no longer a shitty American. But what happens if you're from Italy and you walk into the bathroom and you walk out? What are you?
You're a shit in Italian.
No, European, dude. You knew that.
You're European. You are a peen.
Yeah, incorrect grammar, but European.
I get it now. That took a while to register. I don't know why, but...
That's funny, European. Because there's a cash register.
A cash register?
That didn't register.
Oh, it didn't register as in a cash register.
No, but like, I don't understand what the cash register, why it's called a register. Because it's registering a transaction. Like, you're saying it took a long time for it to register, meaning to process or to sink in.
Yeah.
And I guess processing a transaction is what a cash register does.
I wonder if that's rooted in the English language, and they're all comparable because of that reason. Like, I wonder if it all goes back to, like, economy type things, you know, like cash register, registering a purchase. I'm registering that. I'm processing that, processing payment. Or I wonder if that system of, like, this is a payment, I'm processing it, did that come from... the pre-existing processing or, registering, right? Like, which came first? The chicken or the egg? That's my question.
Yeah, and most certainly the chicken came first. But when it comes to you wondering about the origins of words and how much the way a market functions and what is in the market affecting the language, I'm sure it's... very substantial. In a large market, the common tongue or the common language spoken at that market would have a large effect on the other parts of people that interact with those people. So sometimes there's words that linger on in the brains of the masses, even though the market no longer has those types of things, but it's part of the spoken tongue, and then new ones evolve. Like process probably started out with one form, and then processed started, like, there's a way that people process their food, right? Processing, like a factory, they're making corn chips, and the way they crush up the corn and, you know, do the mixtures, that's a process. Then in the days of the electronic community, now these electronics can process information. It's the same kind of thing with the food, but it's taking on a new form. And then we're able to use that in our common language kind of like as a metaphor or a way to, like, use this concept in a single word.
Yeah, definitely.
That's what words are, I guess.
Yeah, they all essentially, I mean, are connected in many different ways. I just always, I'll think about a word and I'll say, like, when did this start? Like probably at the beginning, yeah. But then there's some words that are invented later on in a language, right? Mm-hmm. So just taking even the English language as an example, right? It's got Latin roots. It's connected with many of the other Latin languages that are spoken. Mm-hmm.
What kind of leaves does it have?
What kind of leaves?
It's got Latin roots, and there's a trunk and
branches, and then you got little leaves going. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I think it's
one of those conifers or whatever the...
A conifer.
Is it deciduous?
Deciduous.
I think conifer is evergreen trees, so like deciduous is ones that have leaves.
Yeah.
Who knows? Look it up.
I don't know. Here's a question.
Yeah.
Does the English language even have leaves, or does it have pine needles?
Yeah, exactly. Then it would be conifer.
Yeah. But does anyone know? Like, is there a debate out there saying, we know that it's got Latin roots, but does it got pine needles, or does it got leaves?
There's pockets. There's pockets in it.
That's weird. What's going on here?
I think there's, like, major winds going on.
Was that wind? I could hear the wind.
I think that was wind. We were just shaking around.
Could they see that? I hope they can see that in the camera. The
if we do this, the cameras shake a little bit. So
okay.
That was crazy.
Yeah, I didn't know if someone was like a outside, truck
hitting
like...
into us or somebody shaking the. No, it was the wind.
Yeah, because I thought I saw like. So we've got the windows. Here's another little behind the scenes bit for you guys. We've got the windows all closed off with curtains because we want to keep the light contained in here. Mm-hmm. We want to control everything the best that we can. Yeah. And I thought so there's a little bit of light underneath there. I thought just like, you know, maybe 10 minutes ago, I thought that I saw some like shadow underneath there. Could have been someone getting into their car walking by. I didn't know if someone was like snooping around being like, what's going on behind those curtains?"
And they could go fuck themselves.
Exactly. And if they can hear us, hey, we're filming a podcast, all right?
Yeah, go fuck yourself. Anyway,
and go subscribe to the channel.
Yeah, we have 23 subscribers now.
Yes, we do.
Because Zach subscribed.
Oh, he did. Does it show up and register on the thing?
Yeah, Zach.
Oh, thank you, Zach.
Thanks, yeah. Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Head, or whatever it is. But this debate is like, there's English from England, there's English from here, there's English spoken different in Alabama than there is from Arkansas, which may be close. I don't even know where the fuck that is. New York, all this stuff. So some of it may be conifers and some may be deciduous. But we can guarantee that the roots are a certain way.
That's true. The roots are consistent on mm-hmm. trees, but there's got to be... minor differences, you know?
Yeah.
Depending on the type of tree and how it
Yeah, they're still in the same genus. You know, like the way that, I don't know, plants are probably categorized in the same way. But the animal kingdom, they have like, it's definitely plants.
There's different families, right? There's like kingdoms, there's families.
Kingdoms, families.
And what else is it?
Species is one.
Species, yeah. There's is there something called class or something? Like classification? Or maybe that's describing the whole entire organization.
There's
system.
Like a Latin, there's Latin names and stuff. But anyway, there's these different categories. And like the English language may just be a species. And then underneath that, there's a lot of different classes or whatever it's called.
Like accents, kind of, I guess, if you were going to describe it one way. Like
yeah, you could say accents.
Yeah, all those languages, they're derived from Latin, and then there's a lot of different other things that are derived from that language, right? Like, you can have, there's different dialects in the United States, even, like, English, there's different dialects in England, Germany, different dialects in Germany, there's different dialects everywhere.
Mm-hmm. And, yes, dialects versus accents. Somebody could speak the... just making it simple. Someone could speak the dialect of the Pacific Northwest, but they could have a Pakistani accent in the way that they're... the accent is something that happens on top of the dialect. The accent is purely an accent. It's like a small... they can still use the same dialect, but their accent is kind of a barrier or a doorway that their dialect has to go through, because like however you learn speech, your speaking mechanism and what kind of tools you have to work with can be learned, but are harder to learn after you've developed them.
Definitely. That here's a question. Do you think there's an American?
There's many.
With
350 mil. Oh.
A Chinese accent.
An American with a Chinese accent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So yes. Like, you think there's one of those, right?
Like somebody who was born in America and then moved to China later on in their life.
A Chinese person who learned English and moved here.
Oh, so you said an American because they have American citizenship, but they're from China.
Yeah, but they're from China. They learned the U.S. language, right?
Yeah.
That exists. Uh-huh. But what about someone with a Chinese accent?
Yeah.
But who also has a Southern accent?
A Chinese Southern accent.
Yeah, imagine that. That's it, like try to imagine what that would sound like in your head. I can't come up with the sound.
I'm imagining many of the Asian languages and dialects happen at a certain pace, so it'd be a pacing conflict.
I think it would be, but also even just the sound, you know, like the sound of both.
Right.
I don't even want to do.
I was doing the Southern accent.
I could tell that I was gonna come in with the Chinese accent.
That's like the pacing. That's how I would do it.
I was thinking about doing it, but then I was like, is this gonna come off bad? Is this gonna sound bad?
Yeah.
Like,
if I was there was this guy from China, I think I told you about him. Yu Gang. Yeah, he told me. Sure, well, that Gigi means suck my dick in Chinese.
Yeah.
He taught me that in high school. And it took me a really long time because there's a sure, like I was telling you, the certain mouth ways you put your mouth. Like in Tamil, which is one of the Indian languages, there's like a D, Jari Chandri G. It's like that. A D is like a Z. It's a G mixed with a T. As Ravi Chan G. But it's like a D. It's a D and a G.
Huh.
It's a D and a GH. So like. Yeah. So it's like that. And I mean, obviously, I don't know what I'm talking about. But sure. Like, that doesn't sound like anything any American. Sure. Well, that is G. And it's G-I-G-I, but it's like Gigi.
Gigi.
Sure, well, that Gigi.
And then, sure, well, that Gigi.
No, that was wrong. Sure, well, that.
Sure, well, that.
Wo, D-O, W-O-D-O, D-A.
Well, that.
Gigi.
Gigi.
Sure, well, that Gigi.
Sure, well, that Gigi.
And I don't even know, like, the emphasis. I don't even, like... The whole thing about the language is the words matter, but the animation behind the words is, you know, a large percentage, over half. So
yeah.
I could know the words of Chinese suck my dick, but I don't know if I was pissed off at someone, I'd be like, sure, well, that's Gigi. But maybe
I feel like you gotta do it with like a sure, well, that's Gigi.
I know, but that's like an American one, but I don't know what they do when they're angry or if they even, cause like even the whole, like, just starting from a family level, they have different, percentages of what emotions that they exhibit, and they have different social rules on what's acceptable in the public realm, right? So I have that from my family level, and then I'm trying to take that over to a different language, which I don't understand. And also, I just don't know what kind of things that are allowed and not allowed in that culture. So then trying to assume or know what – do they even get mad at other people? Like, I wouldn't even know. You know what I'm saying?
I would say that in every, like, culture, there's got to be – there's some outlet of anger that can be expressed, you know, but I think probably the like hand gestures are probably a bit different. And even within that, you know, every society has what they think is acceptable, right? Like, even over here,
yeah,
in a, I don't, the, like, the United States is a melting pot, right? So there's many mm-hmm. different cultures over here, many different ways of expression, I think, which is something unique. But let's say, like, the overall society and what we view as acceptable as a group, right? Or living yeah. in an area. That might be different than what somebody who doesn't accept it thinks. Yeah. So somebody might say something that's not acceptable in society. Like, someone might be joking around with their friends, some young people.
Suck my dick! Ha ha!
And then you're going to have this, like, this old woman who's like, that's terrible. I'd never say something like that to my friends.
Sure.
Someone said that to me, I'd slap them in the face back in the day.
Sure.
And goes into her little shopping Walmart thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
But I think there's many different people within a society who think that who have their own idea as to what they think is acceptable or mm-hmm. what they think is right. funny, and other people don't agree with it.
Sure.
And there's kind of this collective, sure, like, I don't want to say this in society or in a shopping area because it's going to be embarrassing, right?
Yeah,
even younger
rules.
People catch
there's
up on
rules
that.
There's rules to make things run smoothly, and some people don't agree with the rules, but a lot of people abide by them because caked into following the rules is a lot of shame and fear as a young child because they got beaten or they got shamed publicly or privately for doing things that weren't a part of the public's accepted, you know, rules.
Yeah.
We just do this here. That's just one of the things is, like, one of the things that you never want to say or I thought I'd never want to say is because I said so. And I don't like that. Like, if there's a kid doing something, why? Because I said so. But what it really is that person, the adult in that scenario, doesn't really know what their role is. They don't understand the purpose of their role. And really what the purpose of a lot of parents and teachers is, aside from teaching them, is to teach people what the rules of the society are. And yeah. there's a big disconnect because if you don't know you're doing that, then you think you're just trying to make your classroom function. And there's a lot of because I said so. But really, it's like because we don't do that here. We don't do that. That's like you don't speak out of turn and you don't interrupt people and you don't show up late. And you don't fart.
In public, yeah.
Right.
There's but One then again, those. Sometimes, though, I think there's like a rebellious nature where people are like, I think that farts have become more acceptable in society. I think they have. Like, I remember while growing up, it was more of an acceptable thing. I must say, among, like, people that I knew, you know? It was like screw, like, the embarrassment or whatever,
and
right?
And you can do that with friends. Friendships can like, in those private interactions, the global rules do not apply. And so that's where it's challenging to figure out where the rules do still apply and how they've changed.
Very true. I think, though, there's what society thinks, right? And then there's this ingrained system in parenting, teaching, that says there's some things that you have to know to succeed in society. Like, mm-hmm. we don't do that here because it's going to be weird. Maybe you
for
won't
whatever
find
reason.
A job if you start acting this way.
But that's caked into the rules. So, like, if it was acceptable to do, then it wouldn't affect your ability to get a job. So that's not yeah. one of the reasons not to do it. It's just one of the results of having this rule, is if you do it, you'll get in trouble.
Well, right? Yeah, and another, like, side aspect of that's just the way it is. You know, mm-hmm. like, if you do these things, you're not going to find a job in today's society. Sure, if the rules weren't there, it would be different, but right. it's not different.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's other things that are, I think, grouped into there, and there's some things that naturally people who are taught this, some people like to rebel from it a bit, mm-hmm. you know, and they like to challenge it. Or
sure.
you see people who, there's people even online, you know, who they go into public and they just act however they want to act, you know, they act kind of like weird. And some people are, like, weirded out by it in the grocery store or something, mm-hmm. right?
They touch their peepees in the store.
Who knows what people are doing? Like,
yeah.
I think it's a breakaway from societal norms because people are sick of having to suppress themselves in certain settings. But then, of course, there's like there's an extreme of you can't just go running into a grocery store disrupting everyone doing their
right
their daily you know, getting their daily needs met. And I think there's this strange line that no one can really decide where it goes, where it's how much is too far and how can we function as a society but not make everyone all stressed and, like, you know, really serious all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. It seems mm-hmm. like there's a lot of different groups who believe different things are acceptable in our society. And then there's an overarching belief of what those should be. Mm-hmm. And it's what drives most people, because most people accept it, versus there's some groups, and I'm sure this happens all over the world, there's some groups who don't like the status quo and say, well, I'm not going to do that.
Yeah. And so to me, the I don't know who sets the status quo, but it doesn't matter. And kind of what I was saying before was, in order to get people accustomed to the status quo, these teachers and parents who don't know that that's what they're doing, they do a poor job. They do an ineffective job at letting the people they're teaching, letting them know, hey, I'm teaching you this because these are the rules of the society, right? Instead of the people learning, knowing that that's what they're being taught, they are just being harmed emotionally and sometimes physically for not following the rules, and they don't understand why. And so if that happens as a kid, you're going to learn the rules, but you're not going to learn in a healthy way. And then so later on, you may not remember how you learned the rules, but then you realize, I feel bad when I'm following the rules, because the only reason I'm following the rules is because I'm ashamed to do what I actually want to do. And so when they're ashamed and they realize what they actually want to do, it may be... it may get them into trouble, because a lot of times kids are doing stuff and they have they're following some sort of creative spirit. And so sometimes that's out of line of what's accepted, and we just can't have them doing that if we're going to have, like, this whole global system, at least in a country or a community, right? It's not going to work if you're always following this. But if we completely shut that down, then people aren't fulfilled as adults. And so that's kind of another challenge. But it's really important to know. You got to tell people, hey, this is one of the rules, okay? And look, I don't make them, okay? But my job is to tell you what the rules are. And if you do that without making them feel bad, then they can... they can buy into the rules without having their identity be part of whatever their identifying themselves as whatever they're doing. So if they're following the rules, then that's what they are. But instead, okay, I'll follow these rules because they're here because they're helping everybody else, and I'm gonna contribute to the world.
I mean, maybe an important distinction is deciding what these rules' purposes are, because mm-hmm. I think some rules are in place just to facilitate something that maybe isn't that important, and then other rules are there for very important reasons, because without it, society would not be able to function, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's important to explain to people what rules are there for what purpose, right? So that they can decide, yeah. Oh, this rule is important because otherwise all these things are just going to break down over time in society, and eventually mm-hmm. we're not going to have any structure where people can actually live conductive lives, right?
Mm-hmm.
Versus some other ones, maybe it could be, well, people don't like it when you do this. Like, if you're gonna, like, you know, do this, people don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess you can do it. It's not gonna, like, it's yeah. not gonna ruin society if you do. If you want to act a little bit weird, that's fine. This is why people think it's weird. And maybe eventually people won't think it's weird, and people will just not care. But for now, this is how it is. And just going into it and explaining why the rules are there, or what rules exist for what purposes, because then you can distinguish which ones are important and which ones are not important.
Mm-hmm. And sometimes it's not up to the people in smaller groups to decide what is important and what's not important. Because what, like, these rules, some of them are your people misinterpreting what the rules are. They're making more rules than there actually are. I think that's a big problem. And then also, we can talk about why all the rules are there, and change the ones that don't make sense. But changing that for, at least in America, millions of people, hundreds of millions of people, that's where agreeing on new rules would be a challenge. And sometimes when you're on the ground level, I mean, at an individual level, and you just have a few people you're training to function in a larger society, which maybe we were never supposed to function in a society or in a group of millions, right? It's probably hundreds is what we did for millions of years, right? Even like 100 years ago, if you were a farmer, you just were friends, you knew the people around you and whatever, whoever was supplying you with goods and stuff, and that's it. Like, you would still learn the larger, like, you could still go anywhere in the U.S. and, like, know other people, but now it's like the ability to talk about and try to move the larger group of rules it's become a conversation because we can have that conversation. And a lot of people bring up bad ideas, and that's just what it is. And that's just what we're seeing, is we are trying to change the rules, but we don't realize that we're doing that, and that what we're doing, that we're really supposed to just teach people in a healthy way, like how to be a functioning member of society.
Exactly. No, I think there's some things that are just rules that are there because people, how do I put this? Like, people naturally who are directing what direction society should be going in, like to be in control of what conditions they're surrounded by, right? So they are inclined to make more rules, some rules that are perhaps bettering society as a whole, and other ones which are just icing on the cake, basically, for no reason. Mm-hmm. That some people are, of course, not going to like, because one size doesn't fit all when it comes to some things, right? Like, some people aren't going to feel comfortable with certain conditions that some people lay down. And I don't know. I think definitely people need to know why certain rules exist, because then we can know which ones are important, which ones are less important, and we can allow people to navigate. Sometimes we don't know. And if we don't know, then we should be honest about it, and perhaps people can decide how they want to conduct themselves.
But if let's say it a rule doesn't make sense to you, right? So let's say it doesn't, but the rule is there in place. You can realize that you have a choice. You can follow the rule and be accepted. Let's say the rule is undisputed. You don't take your clothes off in public, undisputed. You don't agree with it. So now your choice is, I can agree with it and follow the rule and be accepted, or I cannot follow the rule and not be accepted. And that's a choice. And people can realize that they actually have a choice to abide by the rules. But it'd be hard to change that rule. That's just how people do it.
Unless there was a better way. I mean, I always think with everything there can be a possible better way. I think some people are just either A, afraid to change it, B, they don't want to put in the effort to find a better solution, or maybe even C, that rule has been around for so long, or this Even if you're talking about like a way that society functions, right? Which you could say is a rule of society, but just things that are ingrained in that said society. I think some people are afraid to change it. They don't want to put in the effort, or it's been there for so long, it's just too natural mm-hmm. to even try and isolate sure. out of all these other things that are attached to what we currently have going on.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm not even advocating for not changing anything. That's definitely not what I'm advocating for. But if we just have the awareness that these are made up rules, some of them help us function. But if I do want to function in the world, I'm going to follow these rules to be effective. I'm going to be effective in being able to have the power to change it. Because if you're always sitting on the outskirts, because there's different rings of, and this even this is a limiting graphic or way to slice the information, but there's different rings of people following acceptable behaviors. There's people that get face tattoos.
Yeah, I'd say that's a rebellious nature. Like, imagine, like, there's people who even now, they say, like, oh, that's weird.
There's guys that will tattoo their eyeballs all black.
I have not heard about that. I've heard about contact lenses, but I didn't know people do it permanently. Yeah, that's the whole insane. Thing. Dang.
So there's stuff like that. They're out here, but, you know, it's very complicated because if you're a famous musician like Post Malone, you're not out here. You're in here. But that's based on your profession. And there's different rules based on artistic professions versus professional professions. And so it's really complicated. But then if you want to have face tattoos, then you should move into an area where that's acceptable. And that can be something that you can navigate.
I mean, I think that I think people just need to start accepting people for what they want to look like, especially when it's personal appearance. My personal opinion on that is those people should be able to express themselves openly in society.
They just want to tattoo dicks all over their face?
I mean, if that's what you want to do, I'd say people should just let them be. Just ignore them. Of course, there's like a boundary. Like if you're going to walk into a store naked, we talked about this before, you know, mm-hmm. and there's children around and there's families.
Right, but who gets to make the call is the whole thing. Who gets to make the call of what's acceptable?
I mean, and you know what? Here's another thing. I just immediately went back on that point, right? Because mm-hmm. technically the natural form would be walking around naked, right? And technically in a natural setting. But it's weird because then people like
dude, we're
they,
far
like,
past we're natural.
We're
at
so
this
far
point.
Past it. And there's the internet, you know, and there's kids are being exposed to stuff earlier on too. And I don't know. I can't. Okay, so those extremes like walking into a grocery store naked, right? I can't speak on that. Mm-hmm. But more subtle things like you know, tattooing your face.
But that's subtle to you, doing, right? That's subtle to you, but
then for somebody else, it's like, what is the downside of you having to shop next to somebody who decided to look like that today or who decided to do that with their appearance? Like, I don't think there's any.
Well, because traditionally somebody who does that kind of thing to their body could be dangerous. They could they will be judged on, and this is just how it works now. They will be judged on the rationality, how rational their decisions are. And if they're making irrational decisions in this arena, their physical appearance, then what kind of decisions are they making outside? And can I trust those decisions?
I would say that, like, it's just like none of that person's business, you know? Like,
well, it is. Like, because you got to protect yourself. Like, you have to protect yourself.
That's true. But, you know, I think it's just like it's looking at somebody's appearance and it's just like judging them and saying, this person is doing this. And to those people, I always think, I'm always like, to those people out there, we're judging. We're looking at someone next to them shopping and be like, oh, I wonder if he's a murderer. Get out of here, bro.
But
maybe,
wait,
I'd say the same thing about you. You know what? I'm going to go into a grocery store, and if I see like some like woman who's like trembling at someone with a face tattoo, I'm going to walk up to her and I'm going to be like, hey, you're a murderer, aren't you? And she's going to be like, no, look at how I look. And I'm going to be like, I don't care how you look. I see you have that gray hair, and that gray hair means you're a thief. She's a thief, everyone. I'm gonna. Bro, that's how extreme I would be. Listen, in reverse.
You have to make assumptions. You have to make judgments about people, even if it's not like judgment. You're not judging them as a like. You have to make assumptions about people. So, the rules have been set up for a long time is, if you do this, we're not gonna trust you, okay? And now more people are doing it, and so now there's more people who are doing it who have other metrics of judging within that group of themselves. Okay, so if you're in a group of people that have face tattoos, there'll be other metrics and these subgroups of smaller different rules that you can have. So you can change it in that way, but I really I don't think it can be a conscious effort to say just to bleep out, you know, like the president saying like, all right, guys, we're not going to care about face tattoos anymore. It's not their place to do that. It's the culture's natural evolution. And like, if there's enough people that have face tattoos, there'll just be new rules and there'll be new rules and new people won't like them.
You know, I think, I don't know. So everyone is automatically going to judge people, right?
Yeah.
And even like, you know, I've had judgments before. Everybody judges other people sometimes. It's just natural, right?
Uh-huh.
But what I do have to say is just when someone is like, what I don't like, what bothers me the most is when someone's like, to something that's completely reasonable for somebody to do, right? It's not affecting that person in any way. And they're mm-hmm. like, hey, you can't do that. Like, I have this imaginary person in my head, I imagine that person.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, get out of here. Mm-hmm. Like, that's just what I think sometimes. I'm like, man, I'm like, just let him live. Please. Like, stop trying to, like, come. It's like, I just imagine someone's in their house trying to do their own thing, right? And then someone pops in the window. You can't do that. Get out of my house. Like, I don't want you here. Like, stop trying. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah. I mean, I think that's outside people taking the rules too seriously, or they you know, they have it's so complicated, but these people have problems, insecurity yeah. problems and control problems. So like it could be the rules' fault. It also could be a plethora of other problems that people could have. And at the end of the day, I mean, I'd like to see some different rules and they may not be like social rules per se, but my most effective thing is going to be to accept the rules, be accepted by people, and doing stuff with people and their acceptance and their just follow the rules. You may not have been taught the rules in an effective way, and you may have a rebellious spirit, but what is that rebellion really going to get you? And what is it really against? What are you really rebelling against?
I think that's definitely an important question, but I also think some things are meant to be rebelled against.
Oh, yeah. Like I'm just talking about the specifics of rebelling against social rules for the satisfaction of not following a rule, just to do it. Look, I don't have to follow rules. And then what? Look what you did. You didn't do anything.
Yeah, no, I absolutely agree. It should be constructive, and you should be figuring out what it is that you're trying to target and what it is
if you want to.
Yeah, if you want to. And you know what? If you don't want to, and you're just like, I just feel like being me today, that's fine too, in my opinion. As long as you're not, you know, going and harming somebody or going and, like, just, like, walking into a grocery store and being like, hey, bah, 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 and just start beating somebody up.
Yeah.
And it's like, listen, I think you've taken it a bit far. I think you might have broken a few rules that are in place to protect this individual. Like, don't just punch somebody in a grocery store, you know? Mm-hmm. But if you want to walk in and maybe you want to be like, woo, and start doing a little bit of a dance to the music going on.
Yeah.
I say, hey, you do.
But is that really a social rule, or is that like there's a rule, there's like limits, and then there is what is normal. So that's a distinction, because going in and dancing isn't going against any rule, right? Any limit. But most people don't do that.
I would and say I'm okay it's because with... there's a social rule in place that says if you act strange in this setting, you're weird.
Okay, people may look at you weird, and that's the thing. That's what is that's so important. Just because people will look at you weird does not mean you're breaking a social contract.
But maybe you're obnoxious and people kick you out of the store too.
They would never do that.
They might. If it was a certain setting and maybe you start off just dancing and people are like, oh, that's kind of weird. Like there's levels, right? So he's mm-hmm. dancing, he's weird, people are looking at him strange. It's not socially acceptable to do this in a grocery store, right? That statement can be
It's not socially true. Normal.
It's not socially normal, but it's also not accepted by people. Like, people in the store are not accepting that he's doing that. Just because
they have never seen it before, I'm really drawing a line here and saying, it's different. It's different. Just because it's not normal. Yeah. No, just because it's not normal doesn't mean that it's not acceptable.
But these people are not accepting it. I'm saying, it depends on the person.
They don't understand it.
Let's say,
but that doesn't mean there's a rule there.
It doesn't mean there's a rule, but there's a rule in everyone's mind saying, I'm not accepting this. Uh-huh. No, society has taught
true.
Me
that's not true.
That this is weird.
Maybe that's what you do, but I'm telling you, that's not how I see it.
That's not what I do, but I'm saying that, people who are not accepting it are not accepting it because it's weird.
How do you know what they're doing?
Maybe they're making a weird face and they're thinking this is...
How do you know, though? How are you drawing this conclusion?
Well, because
if you don't do it, then how do you know?
I think there's different levels. And besides, I've never seen this, but let's say there's clips on the internet of people going into establishments and being a little bit annoying, right? And then that annoyance can turn to a point where they have to get kicked out, right? So let's say you're doing the dance, right? People are like, that's weird. And they give you the weird look and they're like, I feel uncomfortable, right? Society is telling me that I am supposed to feel uncomfortable here because this is what I've been grown up with. Or maybe they're showing uncomfortability for another reason, right? They are uncomfortable, though. They're looking weird. They're walking away. They don't want to be around this person, right? Then the person starts going, woo, woo.
Okay, that's a social limit that someone's...
Yeah, and then you're not supposed to, that threshold...
You're not supposed to disrupt other people. But if you're minding your own business and you're dancing, that's cool. Making sounds is a limit.
In this specific store. Maybe yes. The manager could let him stay. Because, let's say that the manager could. Let's say that he could. But the manager says, this has gone past my social limit.
Okay.
And I'm going to kick him out of the store because I think he's disturbing people.
That's his choice, though. And that's not a global rule that he's breaking.
It's not.
Though.
But it's a rule that has been... imposed upon
by that individual
this condition because, by this individual
yes.
But it is still regardless a rule that has been adapted by him, right? And possibly by other people in the store. Perhaps there were five other people or maybe even more who wanted this person to be kicked out. Even when he started dancing, they were like, this is making me feel uncomfortable, get him out of here. I'm just saying that everybody has their own social conditions that they find to be acceptable, and everybody has thresholds for how they feel the social rules should be applied. Social mm-hmm. rules being – I'm talking about just a very fluid idea. These are the rules that society thinks there should be. Not law, not it's written into law that this is how things mm-hmm. have to be, but rather our imagination deciding what – conditions we should all be held to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree 100%, but I'm just saying the biggest rule there is and all the other rules fall under it is not messing with other people. Don't do something that's going to harm or affect or change somebody else's experience.
Yeah.
Okay, so in the dancing one, if you're not dancing so much that you're taking up a lane or you're knocking stuff over in the store, you're not breaking one of the biggest rule, the kind of a derivation of the golden rule, but you're not breaking the biggest rule. People in the store may look at you weird or feel uncomfortable because that's not something that they see over time. It's not habitual for them. They're like they're kind of woken up from their slumber of habit that they do on a consistent basis. They're seeing something they've never seen before. But you as an individual is not being overbearing and taking over somebody's world. You're not affecting them. You're just doing something that nobody's seen on a regular basis. And there's a big difference.
I'd say there is a difference. I think, though, that it all falls under the category of just socialization, right, in public.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just interesting to see what people think is acceptable and what different people think is harmful.
Yeah, so what do we do about this? Because what it sounds like you're saying is you don't think it's acceptable to do things that people aren't used to. And
I wasn't saying that at all.
Okay,
I was
saying people do that.
I was saying that I think a lot of people, there's everyone judges, right? Going back to that example.
Sure.
But what I was saying is that I don't like the person who pops up in someone's window, right? Their own confined space,
yeah,
and says, what you're doing is unacceptable, mm-hmm, right?
Sure.
And the other person isn't harming anybody around them. Right?
Sure.
There's no harm that is being done to other people. And so,
except to that individual. That
individual
feels
but,
like they're being harmed
but then
in some way.
Their argument always is this. It's always like, well, I don't like seeing that. Or they're like, my
okay,
eyes. Or like, I saw you doing a boogie to that dance, and
yep,
that was
and
bad dancing.
Dude, they're out here in the circle of what's acceptable. That person is not doing an acceptable thing.
Yeah, no, exactly. But it's just
they're
like,
not following the rules.
Sometimes I think, like, it's good that we aren't we're not being so rigid anymore, you know? Like, because there's so much stress that comes when everyone's like, don't forget all these social rules, and don't forget that
I don't think people do that.
Like, I think it is caked into society to some extent. I think that there are certain things where we've added so many weights onto, like, what there needs to be. Like, there needs to be structure to, like, our social system, or else things would break down, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I think we've just piled on so many weights. And I don't know when this happened. I don't know what age exactly this happened in our history or in the world's history. I see the weights being moved because people are kind of pushing against what people think are acceptable, right? And I think there's room that's being made where people are being accepted more often. But I also think it's weird that there's so many things that people, like, sometimes stress about. I think it causes anxiety amongst people because they're like, what is everyone thinking about me? Like, what is, like, this one thing could, like, throw everybody off because in the social setting, this, like, one thing is going to, you know? Or I wore this today, so, like, people are going to think that I'm weird.
Yeah,
because
it's out of what people are used to seeing. But as long as it's not sexually graphic and it's not affecting people, I don't think it matters. And so this is a distinction to make of you and I have different ideas of what these global rules are. And so that's one of the challenges.
I don't even know what all of them are.
I know that's
thing.
One
like,
that's
I...
one of the challenges of trying to define them and to change them is I have taken back, like, I felt trying to be rebellious and not wanting following the rules. But one of the rules that I deleted, whether it's actually that's one of the things, like, nobody's going to know what I actually think the rules are. It's just about what other people think the rules are. And one of the things that I've found to not matter in other people's opinions is doing stuff that doesn't affect them. Example, me dancing in a store. They don't give a shit.
Yeah.
I may feel insecure when people look at me, but that's my problem.
Yeah. No, and I mean, I also would feel embarrassed too. I would, because it's something that's ingrained, right? So, I guess all I'm trying to say is that I think, what am I trying to say here? I sometimes get joy when I see some people, pushing against rules that just seem kind of dumb, you know? Like, they're just there to make other people feel uncomfortable and to make sure that other people can say, that's weird,
mm-hmm,
right? And when I say, like, I don't know, and I think it's funny, too. Like, sometimes, like, you know, you'll be seeing things, like, content creators do this all the time on the internet, right? And we all think it's funny. I think it's funny, you know, when something in public happens. You know, people do IRL streams, and weird things happen, right? They act out in public, and it doesn't harm anybody, and it's funny, but it's also kind of, like, cringy. You're looking at it, and you're going, oh, you know, and you even get that, like, that cringe expression. And then you laugh and you think it's funny, you know? And you know what? Another thing that I didn't think about is without these rules, it wouldn't be so funny.
That's the another whole thing. The whole thing, comedy is playing with the rules. A lot of these, the YouTube things and pranks, it's all about, you're not supposed to do this. Look at how this is.
And those can be bad, like the YouTube pranks. Like those can get bad too, because then it's like, some of them are just so bad.
People get injured. People, you know, have panic attacks. Crazy stuff happens. But that's all what it is. And final point, there's one category. People don't do this, okay? And other category, you can't do this. People don't dance in the store. People cannot take their clothes off in the store.
Yeah,
that's,
absolutely.
That's all
I'm
saying. In this category, I don't give a shit about it.
Yeah, and I do want to say, I think...
And by the way, shit.
I think the world is more... Shit. I think the world is more entertaining with all this going on. I'm just saying, like, I think we all need to accept that it makes the world entertaining that people are challenging the rules, you know, or challenging rules that just kind of exist.
Challenging
in
the
a
people
weak
don't do this
way.
I'm cool with.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I mean. Like, people don't do this. I think that it's cool. And
you can't get a face.
That,
you can't get a face tattoo and be respected. That's one of the rules.
Yeah. See, and that's one of the things where I think it's great, and I enjoy seeing the challenge and the struggle there. Mm-hmm. What I don't like is when someone comes in, the most serious person just comes in the room and is like, "You can't do that, bro.
Yep.
You're not a part of society now." And just like, I just imagine like the type of people who like bust down someone's door and is like, hey,
you ever seen
look
that?
What you're doing. You're
you
living in this
that?
House here.
You ever seen, like, that before?
Well, it's an extreme expression, you know, but it's like, you know, when you see those types of people, I'm just like, man, like, why do you have to take it that far? Why? Like, you could just say like, "I disagree with that." Or, "Oh, that's kind of weird." Like, like slap a like, "Oh, that's weird. You can do that." And then just let it be, you know? I don't know.
But then are you trying to control what other people do?
I don't know. I think that, like, we're talking about,
and like, now
like
you're
going back
now
to the
you're
help.
That person, and somebody else is affecting how you feel, and you got to realize for what reason that is. Is that because you're not used to it, or they're invading your personal space by you witnessing that? So,
like, I don't know. I think there's limitations on things, of course, but when there's the person who's that harsh, right? Like, we're talking about, like, the health dictator levels.
But, like, why don't you like it?
I don't like it because then, again, it's a step away from being the health dictator, right? First, you're, like, you're thinking about, like, I'm busting down this person's door and I'm screaming at them for doing this thing that I don't like. Because in my brain, I don't like it. And if there's people around me doing what I don't like, I don't like it. Like,
and I just farted.
Yeah, like, imagine someone comes in and is just like, "Hey," like, into the van.
Right,
and,
but why don't you like that?
I don't like it because it's one step away from the health dictator.
And what's wrong with the health dictator?
The health dictator is controlling everybody's lives. Like,
okay,
like,
why
it's
don't
what we
you
talk
like
about.
That?
I don't like it because it's like, it's none of their business. Like, it's like going back to the
it's none
know,
of their
the
business.
Episode.
That's not a reason not to like it. Why?
But well, because they're going like... in. Like, imagine, like, so if you haven't seen the health dictator. This may not make sense to you, but okay. He's going in. He's stealing their beds. He's still stealing their coffee.
Yeah.
He's saying, hey, like, bruh.
Right.
Like, you have to go watch The Health Dictator. There's a clip. You can watch it. Anyways, that guy, he's going in, and he's just messing with people's lives. It's like, why do you need that much control is my question for that person.
Okay.
Like, some
but
insecurities.
That's not, you're
like,
not
I get
really
it,
highlighting why you don't like it.
But that's why I don't like it. It's because he's coming in and he's saying, "I need to control everybody."
Okay,
and
so
I don't like
you don't
that
like
factor.
It because he's violating one of the rules of you don't do this. You don't step in and take control of other people's lives.
But I think that's one of the things of like the we don't do this for a reason.
Okay,
because it's just it's inflicting It's restricting other people from living how they want to live, and it's also a form of, I would say, suppression. Mm-hmm. And I would even say, like, imagine, like, someone's like, oh, I need this. Let's say it goes another step. I need this to live. I need food, mm-hmm. right? Sure. And then the health dictator comes in. We don't eat food here anymore.
Right.
Like, he's expanded his whole entire prohibition into food.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't like people taking over other people's freedom to choose things.
Yeah, like, I just think it's a dangerous slope and it's a step away. So when I see those people, I'm just like, I don't know. I was like, man.
I see that. I had a point about that. Health dictator. Yeah, I mean, we talked about that for like 40 minutes.
That's a long segment.
Yeah, I think that's good, though. Health dictator points. We don't do this. It's just, yeah, crazy.
It is pretty crazy.
Yeah.
And the health dictator, I mean, I don't even know. Like, I go back to that when I think of, like, the people who are, like, you know, the controlling society. But that was even just, like, when I made that, that was just a joke even. Like, I was just imagining if there was someone like that who existed.
Right.
And there probably isn't. I doubt there's anyone who wants to steal people's beds and steal their milk and steal their coffee for just no reason. Like, it.
Something like that happens. Okay. And this is a segment.
This is a segment.
Yeah. It's called,
new segment.
Wait, no, it's not a new segment.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, I'm trying to come up with the name of the segment.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And this is called, I'm going to have to go to the bathroom pretty bad, so.
Okay. We'll do this quick. So where,
So this is called. God, I have to poop so bad.
There's stores too. QFC. Yeah, like,
I think so.
If you wanted to, I could try to entertain them. Like, I could, and we can cut it out too.
What time is it right now?
It's 1:57. What do we want to do here? Because if you want to go real quick to the grocery store, use the bathroom. What I could do is I'll try to keep them entertained. If it's bad, then we'll just we'll move on.
If it's bad?
Yeah, if it's bad, we'll just cut it out, and then we'll cut back to you coming in. I'll try to entertain them. I'm going to also take out some pistachios, if you guys don't mind. I'll try not to eat into the mic. Just remember, stay in tune for the new segment.
Yeah, I'll think about it.
Or the old segment.
I think it's the first time we're using this segment, though. So it is a new segment, but it's not a new segment.
Very true. It's old segment. And
if this turns out bad, we'll just cut it out. And I think there's a little bit more light exposure, but I think that should be fine. Let's see, what is there to talk about? I had my catalytic converter stolen. That's something that happened that I wasn't too happy about. I just, you know, when you go and you mess with somebody else's car, it's just,
you know, you don't mess with somebody else's car. You don't do that.
And I'm probably gonna talk about this maybe a little bit. I'll be making another appearance on the Chucklehead podcast at some point, but I might talk about this on there too. But I couldn't
believe it. Because to tell you exactly what happened. So first. And I already talked to Jake about this, but...
First, they stole my catalytic converter out of my car. They propped it up.
Stuck a cinder block underneath there and sawed it out. Right, just gutted it. And then
they went to this nice car on the side street where I was parked and just bashed it in the side. Who does that? They just bashed in the side for no reason. There was no monetary gain. They just went over there and just started bashing it right in the side. Then they walk up to the main building where there's two other Priuses parked, right in front of a window, and they slash the tires. Like, what kind of
justice is this? Is my question. There's cars outside. Yeah, people are
looking at me because without the curtain, they just kind of peer inside and probably wondering what I'm up to.
It's kind of weird. Anyways, I don't know. It was just disturbing to me. And you know,
there's something that happens. Like, when something like that happens, I've been robbed before, right? People have broken into my house. And
there's something that happens where, like, you're just so upset. You're so angry, you know? You just, like, imagine if you caught them in the act that you'd, like, bam! You just, like, karate chop, you know? That's what sometimes, like, you imagine. You're just like, you and I don't know if this is normal, but, like, I go through, like, this period, and it doesn't last for long, but it's, like, the short period of just rage, where I'm just like,
I can't believe somebody would do this, you know? And then puts my car out of commission for a week, destroys other people's cars, people had to work the next day, and they were having to call in, and
they didn't know what to do, and now they're afraid to park on the premises, and I just imagine me coming in and just being like, bruh, and just taking, like, a tire iron and just, on all these, like, I'm assuming, I don't know who these people were, but, I don't know, I went through this period where it's, you just get so mad, you know? It's like in the movie, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, you know, where those people, they go to break into
the house, and Brad Pitt is there, he's sitting there,
and he just starts fighting all of them, you know? That's what I imagined. I imagined doing that
to those people. They're coming in, they're trying to steal my stuff.
And I just, and I just, like, you know, take them out. And it was like this moment where, like, you know what's ironic is in that moment, I became the health dictator in a way, because I, like, imagined, I was like, I'm going to find all those people, I'm going to round them up. And, like, I became the health dictator for a moment, you know? And then I had to settle down, and I was like, listen, we're not that crazy, all right? Just a moment of anger. But, man, I just got so mad in that moment, you know? I couldn't believe it. I was in shock, you know? The police were outside when I walked out of the townhouse. I walked out, I was looking, and I was like, God, no. What is it, right? The neighbors were outside because they already knew what happened. Their cars were, you know, one of theirs was pretty much half destroyed, just, like, bashed up and stuff.
And he starts approaching me, and it's like, you know, it's like in those movies, you know, where it's like, God.
No, officer, please don't tell me. It can't be her. Please. Please don't let it be her. Sir, we found her on the side street.
Oh, no. No. Yes. She's propped up. We don't know what happened to her. She might be okay. I remember walking down to the side street. I looked under and I knew. I saw the wires sticking out because it was clipped.
I could see where they sawed the catalytic converter off.
I don't know. And that's when you go into the rage mode. That's where you just think, like, man, just imagine if I was in my car and I was driving and I saw them
trying to jack someone else's car up. I just, like,
just smash. Right in there, you know? But, I don't know, is that normal?
Maybe it's just me.
Maybe it's just me who, like, in a moment is just like, ah.
But I settled down, you know? It wasn't like, you know, it lasted for maybe, like, 5 minutes, and I was like, okay, just gotta move on. But, man, it's so frustrating.
And yeah, that's kind of what happened.
Let's see, what else? Yeah, driving around has been difficult.
You know, you can't really eat. When you're doing a segment by yourself, you know? You can't really eat food, is the problem. Because
you can't talk with your mouth full. So I just noticed, I thought it was the perfect time to eat these pistachios. But it's really not. I really can't eat the pistachios, so
thanks, guys. Can't have my meal because you guys just had to have some sort of entertainment while he was gone, you know? You couldn't just let the segment be cut, you know? Or maybe it will be cut. You won't get anything, alright?
That sometimes is just how it goes.
Let's see. We need another topic to talk about. What else has been happening?
I've been working on a
YouTube video, you know? But, a problem with when you try to make a YouTube video that I've noticed. So, my strategy for this, and I don't know what other people do, but I turn on a camera.
Basically, and I have, like, an outline script. And then I have other stuff that I'm going to interact with, right? Like, I have a video or something. I have, like, maybe a little bit planned, but I try to keep it mostly improv. Because that works better for me. But when I put all these clips of me talking and all the different content that I'm looking at, and what I don't want to spoil the video, but there was, like, a video in there, and there was some other stuff that involved me using OBS to do the screen share thing. And there was so much footage. It equaled, like, without it being edited, I think it was almost 45 minutes. And I was looking at this, and I was like, man, there's so much. And there's so much stuff that isn't good that you have to cut out. And I feel like it's just, oh, I don't know. I don't know. I'm going to have to see how it turns out. Because then there was other stuff that I need to film separately, which was going to make it even longer. And I narrowed it down a bit. And then I realized it was still like 30 minutes. And I have to cut more. I'm not going to have a 30-minute video on some random topic.
That's ridiculous. It's like this segment. It's like this segment. I don't know. Like, what do you guys think of this segment? Is this a bad segment? Because this is feeling a little bit like a bad segment to me. It feels like...
It just feels like this segment isn't very good.
You know? Sometimes there's a bad segment and you don't know if it's good until it's edited, but I feel like this is a segment where I
know it's a bad segment, and even when looking at it after doing it, it's still going to be a bad segment. You know? I don't know. What else is there to talk about in here? We've got the Pope, we've got George Bush, and we got Russia over there. It's a little joke in the podcast. I always wonder what people think when they, you know,
if you just find this episode or a previous episode and you just look and you're like, oh, they have the Pope and George Bush and the Russian flag in the background. What does this mean?
And people are looking at me again in the car. They just stopped, and they're just waiting to turn, and they're just looking, just watching. Oh, now they get a close-up of me. Hello. Hello, people. So weird. Such a weird feeling, you know? I wonder what they think. Like, I just have this mic here, and I'm just, like, doing weird stuff with my hands, being really expressive. I wonder if they think I'm a YouTuber. It'd be kind of funny. Either that or they think I live in this van, and, you know, my YouTube career hasn't gone very well. I have one subscriber.
I don't know. And he's back. I think that was a very bad segment.
You think?
Yeah, I tried carrying it for, like, for a while, and it just... I just talked the whole time. I mean, it...
Okay, that's cool.
I don't know. I don't know how I feel about it, though.
Maybe that was episode one of your solo podcast.
Oh, I don't think I'll do a solo podcast. That's... that was very bad.
We'll
that felt very bad.
We'll see what it looks like.
All right, all right. And I realized I couldn't eat, too. I was talking about that to them, how, like, if you're going to do a solo thing on a mic, right?
Yeah.
You can't eat.
Well, you can.
I mean, you can try, but, like, I started popping some in my mouth, and I was like, I can't talk while I chew. It's going to make them angry. So, I don't know. I'm just going to wait. I'll wait till after. A lot of random topics that I put in there. I was talking about George Bush, the Pope, and Russia, and how, you know, if they haven't seen the episode with the Giorgio and Francio and Russio bits, they should check those out.
Yeah, there's many of those.
People were looking at me through the window, too.
You think?
Yeah, because there wasn't a curtain. There was, like, a lady who walked by on the other side of the street, and she kind of, like, glanced over, and she was like, what is going on here? And there was a car that was pulling in, and they also kind of gave me a weird look. And then the rest of the time, I just ignored the outside world. But safe to say, I got some very interesting looks. I wonder, do you think they can see the Not Your Cousin's podcast sign here? Do you think that's, like, free advertising? It's probably too far away, yeah.
Oh, they can't see it.
What if we put it on the curtain outside of the window?
Outside, yeah.
Yeah. Maybe they'll be interested in searching us up.
I think we can do that. Yeah, so speaking of rules...
It's just anytime you go into a public bathroom, I swear every single time the toilet seat has pee on it.
Yeah. I know what you mean there. I always put down little pieces of toilet paper on the
I know, but you have to wipe it down first.
Yeah, you do. I know, it sucks.
It's like, bruh. And I was in it was a major emergency.
Yeah, I don't understand.
I had to pee in the urinal first because the regular toilets weren't available, and I needed to do both pretty bad.
Yeah, figured you might as well relieve one and then.
Well, because there was two guys in there.
Oh, there were.
Yeah, smelly guys. So it's not the best. And QFC wasn't very close. But anyway, this is a new segment called Freestyle Live.
Freestyle Live.
Yeah. So here it is.
All right, here it is. Okay, let's get into it. Okay. Ooh, we got two of them.
Yep.
All right.
Did it give you access?
Let's see.
Should have given you.
It has, I believe. Yes. Now it's just loading. I'm not connected to internet, so it should be fine. It's not playing, but it is playing, if that makes sense.
It's plugged. Oh, yeah, it should.
There we go. Okay, we'll start from the beginning. I'll try to turn up the volume here so that's good.
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay.
It's playing, but it's not playing. What the fuck are you saying?
It's a plane, it's a plane.
Yeah. Burdens.
Blame on Burdens. Existence.
Hey, 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 hey.
Last night I rode on a giant
bus.
Plane. It was a plane of existence.
It
insane.
Was an Airbus plane. What? Hey.
Airbus is the name of my bust in my house.
You got a bust of a Greek god. He said, oh no, help me God.
Why God, have you done this to me? Are you trying to prison me or let me free?
Shoot me out in the streets, they don't wanna find out. Shoot me in the streets, cause it is night
hot.
Out.
Hot, hot,
hot fire.
Hot, hot,
hot, hot fire.
Hot.
Hey there,
ho,
little
ho,
boy. Hey there,
ho,
little girl. What is
hot,
this? Oh,
hot,
what kind of
hot,
world are
hot,
we living
ho,
in? Spinning
ho,
around and
ho,
living with
ho,
all these things
ho,
that keep going on forever
ho,
and ever. Never wanted to live, never wanted to die. Who are you? Do you even eat fried chicken?
Will you let me fly? Let me die.
Hey.
Ha. Ha. Ho.
Peepee chicken, get licking, finger looking good.
Ha.
You don't wanna fuck around, cause you never wish you would.
Ho.
Find
ho,
out, find out
ho,
that it's
ho,
gonna be night
ho,
out.
Ho.
The night owl spoke, and he's dead, bitch. And he's dead, bitch. Get lost, bitch.
Get lost. In the sauce, saucy in my mouth.
Yeah, bitch.
Refry it like
yeah,
a bean in a house.
Hey, don't call people beans, it's not nice. But you wanna get that shit when you get fried rice. Chicken little, hey.
I'm a bean.
The sky's falling.
I'm a bean.
Little bean. Yeah.
I'm a bean
what
and
you
I'm
mean?
A green
oh,
bean. I'm
what?
A green bean.
Hey, that's green. Hella green. That's so cool. Is that okay? Will Jeff Bezos like you in 2023?
He sells me by the can. Calls me little fucking veggie man.
That's no go. I mean, some of these things are not good. But we'll see.
All right. I think we did that previous one before, too. I don't know for sure, but it sounded very familiar. But then again, we've actually done a lot of these. We have quite a collection.
Yeah, it's a fun segment.
It is. I like it.
Mm.
Can they see the pistachios? I hope that's not distracting. But I'll just put that down. Sorry, guys.
Okay, we're just going to go with this one, even if it sucks.
All right.
My internet's techie.
You know, mine isn't behaving the best today either. It's taking a while to load these songs.
Super hot fire.
Hot fire. Okay. We are in a distant land.
Who are you calling a distant land?
I'm calling you a distant land.
I am a hawk.
Oh. Please, leave me alone. Go. I'm the mouse. Go.
Bitch, I'm flying. I'm coming. I'm coming down to kill you. I'm coming. I'm grinding. I'm coming down to stab.
I'm a little mouse. I'm a little mouse. I'm a little mouse. And I live in a little house. I'm a little mouse. And I'm trying to get away from the big bird in my house.
Hey, bitch. I'm coming to steal your wife, your kids, and your soul. I'm coming to eat your life. Bitch, I'm ready for a bowl of soup or cereal made of mice. That sounds real nice.
Stir it on some hot rice. I'm a tiger in the woods searching for my next
oh, shit.
Meal. Gonna steal some mice in my rice.
Hey, bitch, I'm an elephant. I'm coming and I'm magnificent. Nobody wants to visit or ride on me cause that's not very nice. Hey.
I'm a little hummingbird. I'm a little hummingbird and I fly real fast.
Oh,
fly real fast, how, and I'm gonna go
how,
so fast.
How fast? Okay, I'm a hunter. I'm made out of meat. So why don't I kill my friends that are in my fleet? I don't know, cause I'm so on this for as fish as this. So spicious a fish gish, whoa.
Buffalo, buffalo, buffalo.
Buffalo riding.
Buffalo,
buffalo. Buffalo riding.
Buffalo.
Buffalo riding.
Buffalo. Buffalo, buffalo, buffalo.
Fish flamingo, I'm coming in. I'm like a mango, so sweet and tasty. Oh, don't you chase me. I can't fly. I just stand on one foot.
I'm an apple. I'm an apple crunch. And I have seeds.
Crunch, 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 crunch.
An apple man.
Crunch, crunch.
I'm an apple man.
Crunch, crunch.
I'm an apple man.
Crunch, crunch.
I'm Apple Jack cereal.
Crunch, 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 crunch. This section of the song better end soon.
Maybe
little
well.
Mousy.
Oh shit! Maybe it is now. Oh,
mousies, snack on an apple.
The mouse is dead again. Is gone.
Mousy snacking on apple.
Kill the mouse is gone.
Hey, bitch. Apple.
Hey, hey, baby.
Good ending. It's making me think that we're probably just gonna we'll be in good condition to just do one more. Like it seems like it takes two to at least one, and maybe not, and sometimes two to get, you know,
warmed up. I like the first one too, though. I felt like that was pretty good.
Yeah, I'm discovering my the best voice for this.
We got some good harmonization there. At least I can never tell in the headphones, like, 100% sure, but some of those bits sounded pretty good, you know?
Sometimes. And I felt the harmonization, too, and then it's hard, like, once both voices are playing, then not, like, moving. It's not always, like, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? You don't know which one's you.
I definitely know what you mean, yeah. It kind of all gets, what do you call that? Just like, all kind of like, mushed together, you know?
Yeah, it's hard to differentiate. Okay, definitely. So, there's one option. If all it right. sucks, I'm going to play another one, copy another one.
All right. Should we listen to it first? Do a little listen?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Like in the birds.
Oh, this is this. Don't do this.
Oh, okay.
This is a real song.
Okay. Okay. Try the next one.
Steven.
I think we've done this one before.
No, this is one of the Hidden Tricycle songs, but I don't think there's any. Oh yeah, I can't do this one either.
Okay. Okay. Is that a new one that
Bongo
you sent me?
Bongo
Drongo.
Did you see Bongo Drongo on there?
Bongo Drongo?
Yeah, that's the most. This is the most recent one I sent.
Okay, okay. Oh, I see that. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Bongo Drongo. Yes.
Yeah, bitch.
Holy mackerel.
Hey, bitch.
Holy mackerel.
Whoa.
Holy mackerel.
Holy mackerel. That's a fish.
Holy mackerel.
Hey, bitch. Hey, bitch. Hey, bitch. Holy mackerel. That's a fish.
I'm a fisherman.
What?
I'm a fisherman. Whoa. I'm a fisherman. Hey. I'm a little baby fisherman.
Don't you know?
These stories.
fly in the ocean, fisherman.
Hey, what are you, a fish? I don't even know. Are you a bitch? I don't even know. Can you see the meaning of life from the ocean? Do you even know why you aren't floating? If you got blood inside your veins, but you go underneath the water.
I'm a little fisherman. I'm flying the ocean blue. Ooh.
Running across, running across, running across, running across. I'm a flying squirrel. I'm coming to kill you. Eat all your pearls, eat all the girls in the world. What you gonna do? How you gonna repopulate?
Fisherman's world. Yeah.
Fisherman's girl. Fisherman, fisherman, fisherman squirrel.
Hey. It's a twirly world.
World in the twirly world. World in the twirly world.
I'm trying to do the twirl.
I'm trying. I'm trying.
I'm a little twirl.
Whoa! Are you a little twirl? Are you a little girl? Are you one in the world? Are we really here? Can you tell where our brain is? Can you even tell that we're going insane with all of these things that you show us on the TV? I don't even know if my name's Stevie. Steve-O goes blind because he can't show all the things in his mind, so he won't go. Can't stop, can't go, can't drop, no. Everybody wants to learn how to do techno when it was the 80s. But now what you doing now? You're my lady. Or do you even know where you are? I'm crazy.
The best beat, but I think
that was difficult.
The ending was cool.
That was difficult to work with. That definitely was like.
Yeah, we got to. I got to vet the beats before.
That it was interesting though. I definitely think the previous two were better though.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, you never know until you edit it. That's
right.
The one rule that I think we found to be true is that we can think something is one way, but we'll never know until we edit it.
Yeah, and we still may never know.
True.
Okay, this is a new segment called New Segment.
Oh, man.
Jesus. And when,
that gets me every time.
And they can never see us, what we're doing when after I say New Segment. But it's still funny when you say, whoa, and you go like this. It's still funny.
Because I'm seeing it.
Yeah.
Like, I can, I'm not kidding. I can actually see it. And
yeah.
Every time it amazes me.
Yeah.
Because it just pops into reality.
Mm-hmm.
Every time we say new segment, it's
right.
Unbelievable.
Right. Okay, so this is a new segment that we call Say Something That Doesn't Make Sense But Makes Sense.
Say something that doesn't make sense but makes sense.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to go first.
Okay.
And you look into the camera when you do it.
Okay.
After the first dawn, the daughter comes forth and reminds us the autumn has come, and it has passed, and so are winter.
Damn.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I don't have anything. I don't think that good, but let's try something, okay. The popeth of all popes and the silvereth of all nopes will grace said pope with George Bush's scalp. For thy scalp is the scalp of the silver pope.
Yes. I like that. The council. It was about the council. So that was that segment, and yeah.
I liked it. I actually enjoyed that segment.
Yeah.
I like it. I do.
Yeah, I think she's basically say nonsense, but try to, you know, get at least something in there.
Yeah, that segment had like, I don't know how to describe it. It spoke to me.
Okay.
It had something going that I really liked.
Cool. Any last words?
Any last words? I cannot think of any. No.
Sorry. Any last words?
Oh, no. Oh, no. Help. Help.
Hey, George, do I really have to do this?
Help. Pope.
You have to do this.
Pope. Okay. Pope, hey, why aren't you doing anything?
Mr. Pope. I have come. I've been hired to kill this man. Do you have anything to say for you?
Sober Pope. What? Stop looking like that. You're not. Stop looking at me.
I am a werewolf. I'm coming to kill.
That's why he's scared. He's not saying anything. You're just staring.
He must stay away from
Pope,
me, or
please.
You.
I know I haven't ever...
Five.
I'm praying to God. Can't you see? Please.
Four.
Oh, God. He's not listening to me.
Three.
Oh, God.
Two,
George. Giorgio. I love you, man. I'll switch parties. Please. Oh! Ah!
Okay, and the episode's over.
The episode's over. That's the end.